गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, टू द कम, सम ऑफ यू आर कमिंग टू नाउ, गुड आफ्टरनून टू एवरीवन. So we are waiting for the students. Let me wait for 2 minutes. Then we'll start with the class. So yesterday we were doing this question number six of the last exercise. If to someone it is not clear, I'll explain again. Otherwise, the solution is very short. Three steps here, and done. If anybody wants, sir, explain question number five. Okay, question number five. Fine, I'll explain that question number five. So Gagan, just see solution of question number 5. By this time students are coming, no? Just see Gagan on the screen. I hope it is visible to you. Okay, Ankush, let me see. Removed, Ankush. Okay, look here now. Gagan, just see this in question number 5, no? See the figure first of all. Here, no, we have assumed it Z, this angle Z. Okay, see this. There is a formation of Z. Yes, and in the question it is given that PQ is parallel to ST, or PQ is parallel to SR, it is given. If PQ is parallel to SR, then it will be parallel to ST also. It means this line is parallel to this line. If the lines are parallel and there is a formation of Z, it means this angle and this angle are equal because of alternate interior angles. Is it clear, Gagan? This point. So this angle means here we have two angles, x plus 28, and this side we have 65. So x plus 28 is equal to 65 degree. See this. X plus 28 is equal to 65 degree because of alternate interior angles. Is it clear? Here I have written PQR, the name of the angle. PQR and QRT are equal. And because of this, we got the value of X, that is 37 degree. Good afternoon to all those who are coming now. Is it clear till here? Gagan, just reply so that I should know. It is your problem. So I want to know from you. Okay. After this, after calculating the value of X, we have to calculate the value of Y. So here, no, it is, this is not required, Z, because fine. So look here now, in this triangle, X plus this 90 plus Y is equal to 180 degree because of angle sum property. See this angle sum property, X, Y, and angle B 180, and angle B is 90, x we have calculated 37, we can calculate the value of y here. It's done. So see once if any confusion you have, then ask. So if any one of you want the explanation of question number 6 again, you can tell me. Otherwise, we are moving on to some of the examples now. So for today's no, for today, we are moving to some of the examples. Okay, some are saying, sir, please explain. Fine. Okay, I am explaining question number 6 one time. Those who have not understood yesterday, they can see. And those who have understood, it is better to see it again. It will be a revision for you. No need to do examples in notebook. You can practice examples in your practice notebook and all. Okay. Devender. Look at everyone. We have this figure. And here now we have assumed all these angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 5, 6, there's 1, 2, and this 3 and 4. Okay, and what is given in the question that QT and RT are angle bisectors. This line QT is the angle bisector. It means QT is originating from this point. Okay, and it is dividing this angle into two parts. So 3 and 4 will be equal to each other. In the same way, RT is angle bisector. RT divides this full angle into two equal parts. So 5 and 6 will be equal to each other. Okay, now what is given means what we have to prove. We have to prove that QTR, which is this QTR, angle 1. Is half of angle 2PR. So it's half of this angle. So let us see how to prove this. I have told you yesterday that we have to use here in this question exterior angle property. And I have started yesterday with this triangle. See this triangle PQR. If you will look into this triangle PQR, then we have one exterior angle for this triangle, which is angle PRS. See this? PRS means this angle is exterior to this triangle. And because of this, we can write here that PRS is equals to angle 2 plus angle PQR. PRS means this angle is equals to angle 2 plus PQR means this full angle. So this angle is equal to this plus this. This is exterior angle property that you are doing since 8th grade or 7th grade. Okay, so I've written that. Now, one point that you have to keep in mind that here we have to do half of each and every angle. Just do half of each and every angle here. So half of PRS, half of angle 2 and half of angle PQR. Okay. This half thing, you know, you can just see into this what we need to prove. Here also we have something half. So that's why I have done here half of each and every angle. So after writing half of each and every angle, after that you can write here that half of PRS will be angle 6. Look here, half of PRS. PRS, what will be the half of PRS? It can be angle 5 also and can be angle 6. But we have to take angle 6. Why? You will get to know from here when we will proceed further. And yesterday I have told you the right angle we have to take means this angle. We have two angles, no? And the left side 5 and the right side 6. So this angle we have to take. Okay. So in place of P, half of PRS, we will write angle 6 here. In place of half of PRS, we have to write angle 6. And half of angle 2 we can't do because there is only one angle, that is 2. So half of angle 2 just remains same. And half of PQR we can do. PQR, half of this angle is angle 3 also and angle 4 also, but we have to take angle 4. So we'll write here angle 4. Then let it be equation number 1. And how we have done this half and half? Because QT and RT are angle bisector, it is given in the question. Just write this QT and RT are angle bisectors. After that, now we have to move into this triangle. And if you look into this triangle, then we have an exterior angle, that is angle 6. In triangle TQR, by exterior angle property, we have angle 6 as exterior and interior are angle 1 and angle 4. So angle 6 will be equal to 1 plus 4. So angle 6 is equal to 1 plus 4. Now see this. This is equation number 1. And this is our equation number 2. Now compare these two equations. This is also equal to angle 6 and this is also equal to angle 6. So angle 6 and 6 is removed. Now this equation will be equal to this. So 1 plus 4 is equal to, which we have written here, half of angle 2 plus angle 4. 4 and 4 cancels out as they are same. So 1 is equal to half of angle 2 and 1 is QTR and 2 is QPR. So it's done here. Rest I have told you that a practice is required for the question. Rest we are starting with today examples, and 3 examples we are going to do today. And even which are important enough, the way we have done this question. So example number, we'll start with example 2. Just take out example number 2 in your book, or you can look here at the screen. Here I have here example number 2. Pop it from your book. In figure 6.10, this is figure 6.10 as per your book. In figure 6.10, ray OS stands on a line POQ. See this, there is a ray OS which is on POQ. So OS stands on POQ. Fine. Then OR and OT are angle bisectors. Here OR divides this angle into two equal parts. So this part and this part are equal. In the same way, OT is also the bisector of this angle on the right side. And here also this part of the angle and this part of the angle are equal. It is your choice. If you want to write these questions, the 3 examples which I am telling you in your notebook, you can write in your notebook to maintain the notes. Otherwise, you can write these 3 questions which I am explaining today in your practice notebook. Simple. It is up to you. If you want to mention these examples in your notebook, you can write that. Okay. So what is given? Let us write first of all that OR and OT are angle bisectors. Okay. And nothing else is given. One more thing is given that angle POS is X. So they have assumed angle POS, this full. POS, this full angle is X from here to here, means POS. This is X. Now we have to find ROT. How to find angle ROT? How we can find this? ROT. Let's start. Since this we have written already, let us write here only. Since angle POS is X, so okay, no need to write since, just directly we can start. Angle POS, just see carefully in the figure, angle POS and SOQ makes 180 degree linear pair. Let me clean this. See, this POS is X. See, POS and SOQ. So they are making a straight angle, 180 degree. So that's why we can say that they are making linear pair. Is it very much clear? So POS is X as per the question. SOQ we don't know. So what will be the value of SOQ? that will be 180 minus x. Okay. So we will use it further. Let it be equation number one. Now see this in the figure I'm explaining again. We have to find ROT, and ROT includes two angle. One is this and one is this. You have to just see the relation which is given in the question. ROT includes two angle, ROS and SOT, SOT and ROS. Now if I'll talk about you that ROS is half of POS, yes or no? ROS, this angle, is half of this angle because OR is the bisector. In the same way, this angle means SOT is half of SOQ. Why? Because OT is the bisector. So let me write to explain you better. So writing this side, that angle ROS is equal to half of angle POS. ROS, this angle which I have marked here, is half of POS. Why? Because OR bisects angle POS. Yes, no, OR, this line OR is bisecting this angle, this full angle, into two equal parts. So that's why we can write this reason that ROS, this angle, this ROS is half of POS. Okay, and POS we have assumed means it is given in the question that POS is X. So it is half of X. Sarang, you have come now, you are asking this question. Is this? This is example number two, Sarang. Example two we are doing. Example two and few more examples we will do today. Okay, note it down. Now, if ROS is half of X, now see this. Also, this right here also. Angle SOT is half of which angle? Let us see. I have told you that we have to calculate ROT. In ROT, we have this angle, ROS and SOT. ROS we have written that is half of POS. Now we have to look for SOT. Now SOT is half of SOQ. SOT is half of SOQ because OT is the bisector. In the same way we will write, SOT is half of angle SOQ, and reason, OT bisects angle SOQ. OT bisects angle SOQ. After this, we can write here, in place of SOQ, we can write this from equation number one. It's right here from see, from the first equation, SOQ, we have written 180 minus X. In place of SOQ, we have to write now 180 minus X. Now, we can solve further. Half, we can multiply inside with this and half with this. And this is equals to 90 degree. So, it is equals to 90 degree minus half of X. Okay, and let this equation be this ROS be equation 2, and let this equation SOT be equation 3. Now add these two equations. Add two. If you don't want to add, no, you can write like this also. Okay, add. It will be better. There are many ways, no, many methods to do a question. So I'm just telling one of the way. So ROS and SOT, let us add this. ROS plus angle SOT. Anyone can tell me which angle it will make? ROS plus SOT from the figure. ROS plus SOT. We are adding these two equations. Let me highlight this. This equation and this equation we are adding up. The left side to the left side and right side to the right side. Now right side is, yeah, it will make ROT which we require. So two students have written, yes sir, ROT. That also we have, then only that only we have to calculate. So half of x plus here 90 degree, then minus half of x. Now ROS plus SOT. Look here, ROS this angle plus SOT this angle together it will make ROT. So that's why we have to write here ROT. And here we can cut this. Plus half x minus half x cancels out and it is equals to 90 degree. This only we have to calculate. And we have calculated. This is the only answer. Note it down. Yeah, you can write in notebook. As the questions are very important and good, you can see from the solution. Yeah, I have given you a choice. It is up to you. If you want to write, you can write. Note it down. We'll move to the next question after this, and that will be example number 5. After this, example 5. By the time you can read that. And example 5 is easier than this. I hope you've written now. Moving on to the next. This is kind of statement question. In which figure also we have to make by ourselves. If a transversal intersects two lines, such that the bisector of the pair of corresponding angles are parallel, prove that the two lines are parallel. Okay, let us make first of all two lines. First line, second line, these are the two lines. Let us name them A, B, C, D, and it is intersected by a transversal. Suppose this is a transversal, means transversal line cuts two parallel lines, something like this. Okay, so this is the transversal which cut this two line, and it is, let it be E, F. Now let us read the question. If a transversal intersects two lines, so it is a transversal which is intersecting two lines, such that bisectors of the pairs of corresponding angles, first of all, mark corresponding angles here. Corresponding angles. These are corresponding angles. And the bisectors of these corresponding angles are parallel. Okay, let us draw the bisector of these corresponding angles. So bisector of this and the same way bisector of this. And it is given that these two lines are parallel. These two lines are parallel. So let it be A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. So I have named all the points. Now let us write given. AB, just wait. See this, first of all, right, see here, bisectors of the pair of corresponding angles, these were the corresponding angles and the bisectors of these corresponding angles are parallel. So it is given in the question that GH line is parallel to IJ. These two lines are parallel. And what is given else? Bisectors are given. GH and IJ are angle bisectors. GH and IJ. GH line and IJ are angle bisector. It is bisecting this angle into two equal parts. And it is also bisecting the angle into two equal parts. To prove, what we have to prove? AB. We have to prove that the two lines are parallel. These two lines, AB and CD. So AB is parallel to CD. And proof. Let it be 1, 2, this be 3 and 4. Okay. So, let us write here first of all that GH bisects angle. Which angle it is bisecting GH? EGB. EGB. GH bisects EGB. Therefore, angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Let us write this in the beginning. No, that's why I am just writing. It will be useful for us in the proving. After that, IJ bisects angle G. ID. IJ bisects GID. Therefore, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Okay, this is just the beginning. So let us go to the main point now. I'm writing this side now. Since GH is parallel to IJ, so the line GH, the red line, both the red lines are parallel to each other. It is given in the question. If the lines are parallel, so we can say that angle 1 is equal to angle 3. This is the main point. If you are able to visualize the figure correctly, no, then you can say, yes, sir, 1 and 3 are equal because of corresponding angles. Who are agree with this that 1 and 3 are equal because of corresponding angles? Now let me explain you how 1 and 3 are corresponding angles. Now I am making only these things. GH, IJ and EF. I am making only this. So there is a line EF. Okay, where we have a point GH and IJ. So GH and IJ. Yes, no, we have GH and IJ. Now just look at this. If the lines are parallel, can't I say this? These are corresponding angles. I have told you that angles on the parallel lines are corresponding to each other. Means these are corresponding angles and they are equal. So these are the parallel lines. And it is a kind of transversal which cuts this parallel line. And therefore, this angle and this angle are equal to each other as these are corresponding angles. There is a formation of F. See this F. I have told you this. So angles on this, these lines of F are corresponding to each other, means are corresponding angles. Okay, so that's why we can say that angle 1 and 3 are equal. If 1 and 3 are equal, we can say that twice of angle 1 will be equal to twice of angle 3. I have multiplied both sides by 2. So I can write after this that angle 1 plus angle 1 is equal to angle 3 plus angle 3 because I have written twice of angle 1. So 2 times I can write angle 1. Here also I have written twice of angle 3. So 2 times I can write angle 3. Now let this equation be first and this be second, and we can write here from first and second. As angle 1 and 2 are equal, so in place of 2 we can, in place of this 1 we can write angle 2. As angle 3 and 4 are equal, so in place of one of the 3 we can write angle 4. Now what is 1 plus 2 and 3 plus 4? See this, what is 1 plus 2, which angle it is making? 1 plus 2 is making EGB. EGB, 1 plus 2. So in place of 1 plus 2, we'll write angle EGB. And in place of 3 plus, and 3 and 4, we'll write GID. So angle EGB and angle GID are equal to each other. And we can write, see this now. If these angles are equal, full, so we can write that, but these are pairs of corresponding angles. Yes, no. These two are corresponding angles, therefore AB is parallel to CD. But these are pair of corresponding angles. Therefore, AB is parallel to CD. See, if lines are parallel, then only corresponding angles will be equal. But if corresponding angles are equal, if corresponding angles are equal somehow, it means the lines are parallel to each other. Note this in your notebook. Note it down. Be quick. If somewhere no any step is not clear, then ask. Let me explain the things again. Okay. Student is saying, sir, it is clear. If your concepts, if the theorems, if everything is clear, no, then the questions will be clear to you easily. If the concepts, theorems, the properties are not into your mind, then it is difficult. Harman is asking, sir, which chapter we are going to start next? The next chapter, seventh. Seventh in continuation. 1 to 8 in continuation will do. Okay. 1 to 8. Yeah. Okay. Clear? Fine. Good. Okay, sir. After angle 1 equals to angle 3. Fine. So I'm explaining from here. Look, Aditya Man. If you have understood that 1 and 3 are equal, then we can say that twice of angle 1 and twice of angle 3 are equal. Why we are doing twice? Look here. How we can prove that AB and CD are parallel? We need know something. To prove AB and CD parallel, there should be these two angles equal to each other. Because if these two angles we will be able to prove equal, means full, these full two angles, if we will be able to prove equal, no? It means they are corresponding angles, and corresponding angles are only possible if there exists a parallel line. Okay, so how we can reach to this full angle? And because of this only we have done here twice of angle 1 and twice of angle 3. Twice of angle 1 and twice of angle 3 I have done. See this, twice 1, twice 3, and we can write here 1 plus 1, 3 plus 3, because it is 2 times angle 1. And it is 2 times angle 3. Now, from the first and second equation, as 1 and 2 are equal, so in place of 1, angle 1, we can write angle 2. Here also in place of angle 3, we can write angle 4. It is angle 4. So, angle 1 plus angle 2, it is making now EGB, the full angle. And angle 3 plus angle 4 is making this full angle, GID. Now, if these two angles are equal, but these are the pair of corresponding angles, we have to identify the sequence. This sequence is of corresponding angles, and corresponding angles, if they are equal, it means AB and CD are parallel to each other. this way. Yeah. See, only 2 to 3 minutes are left and the class will get over and I'll not be able to explain you the next question. And it's better to end the class here only then. And see, the next question will be this. You can prepare this question for tomorrow. And it is one of the most important questions of this chapter. Example number 8. And which will take time to make you understand. So I need 15 minutes at least. And which is not possible today. Example number 8. Let me explain you what is this all about. Sometimes, no, this example comes without figure. As it is written that in figure 6.38, so possibility is that figure will come in exam. In figure 6.38, AB and AC are two sides of the triangle, which are produced to E and it is produced to D. AB and AC are the sides of triangle ABC, but AB is produced to E and AC is produced to D. Here BO and CO are angle bisectors. See, BO is bisecting this angle. BO is bisecting this angle into two equal parts. And CO is bisecting this angle into two equal parts. See, in many of the questions, no angle bisectors are given. So you should know the concept of angle bisectors. And with this information, we have to prove this. Here, what we need to prove. Angle BOC, which is this. BOC is 90 minus half of angle BAC. BAC is this. So how to relate this angle and this angle, that only we have to learn in this question. Yeah, our student is saying, sir, it is easy. Means those who have done, it is easy for them. And those who know the concepts, it is easy for them also. Okay. So, the lecture ends here. You can leave. We'll continue tomorrow with the same question. The same page, same question. Okay, bye. Take care. Pleasure. Bye.